folks. So did you have anything interesting happen this week? We kind of did. So Wednesday, late in the afternoon, I started itching in odd places. My ear, at the base of my throat, and on my right arm. Really odd. After a while of this, I actually went to go look to see what on earth is going on. Why am I itching so bad? And all down my forearm, I had these red bumps. They were probably about half the size of a pencil eraser, and quite a few of them. And then as I looked around the rest of my arm, there were a bunch of little smaller red bumps. I was like, this is weird. On my throat, all through my top of my chest here, was more like a solid red rash. I mean, I could see a few larger, more red bumps, but it was just a big solid red rashy area, and it was itching like there was no tomorrow. Very, very odd. So I figured I'm guessing it's gotta be some kind of allergic reaction to something, you know, because it itched so much. I didn't know what, but I started taking Benadryl. You know, that's over-the-counter antihistamine. And didn't think much more about it. The itching didn't get too bad, but the next morning when I got up, it had spread. It was on my other arm, it was on both my legs, and worst of all, my feet were just going crazy. The bottoms and around the perimeters of my feet were itching like there was no tomorrow. So this was really weird, but things took a different turn when I went to take my first sip of something in the morning. I went to drink a sip of tea first thing in the morning, and it was like I had a lump in my throat. You know, I had a little bit of difficulty swallowing. That's weird. You know, I'm thinking my lymph nodes may be swollen, and that's what I was feeling. Because I didn't have a sore throat. Just this kind of lumpy feeling. So I thought, well, maybe there's some kind of infection. I should probably call the doctor's office. So as soon as they opened up, I did. I called them and I explained what was going on. And the receptionist said, oh, you need to go straight to the ER. No, it's not that bad. No. Based on what you just told me, you need to go right to the ER. I'm like, really? No, it's not that serious. She goes, hold on. So she gets the nurse and she puts the doctor's nurse on the phone with me. And I have to explain everything all over again. And the first thing out of her mouth was, you need to go to the ER. I'm like, no, really, it's not that big a deal. I can breathe fine, you know. Because I figured they must be thinking this lump in my throat is, a typical reaction to some allergies where you get constriction and you can't breathe. Well, I was breathing fine. I was having some trouble swallowing. Well, she was adamant, and they couldn't get me into the office. They were booked solid. So she said, at least go to an urgent care clinic. And she gave me the address of a local urgent care clinic. So I agreed to do that. Get there, and sure enough, I'm having a full-blown allergic reaction. We just don't know to what. We never did figure out what. I mean, I don't know if something stung me and I didn't realize it. The only time in my life that I ever have had an actual allergic reaction, like even close to this, I was early teens and I'd stepped on a wasp and he stung me. And I guess it was within about 5-6 hours of the sting that I started having problems breathing. And that was your real stereotypical, I can't breathe very well. It was like I had a 500-pound weight on my chest. And my mom, you know, rushed me down to the ER and that got me all fixed up. And that's what I picture an allergic reaction being, not what I was having. You know, yeah, rash, I know a lot of people have rashes with allergies, and itching, of course, goes with it. But this weird sensation in my throat was odd to me. Well, what it really was swelling in my throat and constricting. That's what I was feeling when I was trying to swallow. So they gave me, with a shot, they gave me a steroid to start working on that. And within a couple hours, the swelling was gone, and I haven't had any problems since then. But the itching got a whole lot worse. Oh my God. So this was Thursday when I went to the doctor's, or the urgent care clinic, and they gave me, they put me on a 6-day run of steroids and an H2 blocker that's supposed to help with it, and had me just continue taking Benadryl, but at twice the dosage I was taking it. And that was supposed to handle the itching. I'm like, okay, fine. I go get my prescriptions filled, and I actually got also a lotion that's supposed to help with itching, because it was really, you have no idea how insane it was making me. All day Thursday, I was fighting this itching. The Benadryl wasn't touching it. It was getting worse. I tried the lotion that the pharmacist suggested. That wasn't helping. Paul Nifferblatz had some cortisone cream. I tried that. It wasn't helping. I went looking online for solutions, and one of the things that the doctor mentioned was I needed to take cold showers, not hot showers, because the hot water irritates it. And so I thought, well, I'll try a cold bath. And as long as I was in the cold water, I wasn't itching. But as soon as I got out of the water, I was itching again. Oh. And then I thought, well, I'll use ice packs. And that brought some relief. But I had itching in so many places. I mean, both arms, my throat, and both of my feet, that by the time I got to the last area icing it up with the ice pack, the first area, within a minute or two, started itching again. I was really going insane. And like I said, the Benadryl just wasn't helping. I tried to get to sleep. I couldn't sleep. I got back up. That night, Thursday night, I got a total of about 45 minutes of sleep. And that was 15 minutes in the 3 o'clock hour. And out in the living room in the recliner, I managed to doze off. And then in the 6 o'clock hour, I managed to get about another 30 minutes of sleep. And that was it. So as soon as that urgent care clinic was open on Friday, I was back on the phone saying, is there anything stronger than the over-the-counter Benadryl that I can take for this itching? And they gave me, they called in a prescription of something else, a stronger antihistamine. So I've been taking that faithfully. And finally now, here it is Sunday that I'm filming this, and the itching is finally kind of under control. I've gotten a little more sleep, not a lot more, but a little bit more. Last night was the best night so far sleeping. But still I have to get up in the middle of the night to take the next dose of the histamine. I wake up itching, and I'm still using the ice packs to cool. Right now it's mostly still my feet and my chest. My arms aren't bothering me quite so much. And the rash is, if I held my arm up, you probably wouldn't even be able to see it because it's not HD. It's mostly gone there, but, it's been interesting. We never did figure out what caused it. I don't know if something bit me or stung me. I mean, the one time I had an even similar sort of reaction was from a sting. There was nothing unusual in my diet. I live a rather boring, you know, humdrum life, and I hadn't tried anything new. I hadn't changed any lotions or anything like that. I'd gone and gotten my hair cut, and so there was the remote possibility that the salon was using a slightly different shampoo. The only thing else I could figure is that because I was going to get my hair cut, I'd put in a pair of old El Cheapo earrings that were just little posts. And I mean, we're talking El Cheapo earrings that, you know, are just, I'm sure, base metal for the fittings, not gold. And even though I've worn them lots of times, it's possible maybe that, you know, use over time, they've gotten scratched up and I had a reaction to the base metal in my ear, because one of the areas that I was itching was around this ear, and the bottom hole where that earring had been was a little on the inflamed side. I don't know. I'm not going to wear the earrings anymore just to be on the safe side. I'd run a few errands while I was out and about. I don't know if I came into contact with something when I was doing that. We'll probably never know. Hopefully it never happens again, because dang, it was so miserable being so itchy. Poor Nifferblatz. We went on Friday because I was taking the new histamine and it seemed to be helping. We went to go do our grocery shopping. Oh my God, I nearly screamed. The heat, this is Florida and it's, you know, August. The heat is extremely strong here, and the heat was causing the itching to just go out the roof. From the time I got into the truck, in the store, but it was worse when we were in the truck, because, you know, a vehicle gets really hot when it's just sitting there closed up, and it's not that long a drive, not much time for the air conditioner to really cool down the cab. So it was unpleasant, and I haven't been out of the house since. hopefully by tomorrow, you know, back to work normal, and I'll be better. I have to go to my regular doctor for a follow-up on Thursday just to make sure everything's all hunky-dory, but anyway, That was our big excitement. Go figure, huh? That's all for this week. Come back and see me. Hopefully I won't be itching anymore.
See ya!